As we begin this journey to Bomet, the Lord has spoken with me this past night. I see rain. Just the mere presence, when I arrive, there will be rain. So we are sitting on the verge of a tremendous visitation.
Look at the clouds gathering.
Natazama mawingu yanajikusanya.
What an awesome time.
Ni wakati wa kupendeza kiasi gani.
I see the rain is coming.
Naona mvua ikija.
It is raining on me.
Inanyesha.
It is raining.
Inanyesha.
It is raining.
Inanyesha.
It is raining.
Inanyesha.
To mega prophet of Jehovah Yahweh, open the heavens in Bomet. Today it is raining. It is raining heavily. For sure, Elijah is here.
It is raining in Bomet. It is raining. It is raining. For sure, it is raining. It is raining in Bomet.
Finally, we are here.
Finalement, nous sommes ici.
Finally, the Lord has brought us here.
Finalement, le Seigneur nous a amené ici.
And it's going to be unbelievable here.
Et ça va être incroyable ici.
I have heard myself.
Je me suis entendu moi-même.
Celebrating.
Célébrant.
Saying it has rained here. It has rained in this meeting.
Cette pluie, la pluie tombe dans le Seigneur. La pluie tombe dans cette réunion.
In this meeting.
Dans cette réunion.
Then I saw the clouds.
Et j'ai vu la nuit.
The cloud of rain.
J'ai vu la nuit et la pluie.
said, it is raining on me here. I said, when I entered here, when I entered here, I said, I have heard myself saying, it is raining on me in this meeting. Hallelujah! And the creepers are walking. Come, my son. President, the pastor is here. Very serious. Hallelujah. 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 The authority of the anointing of the Lord. This is what I talked about. The power of the blood.
Mighty healing service here.
Amanhã será poderoso serviço de cura aqui.
I have seen so much. The Lord will show me so much.
Eu já vi muito. O Senhor já me mostrou.
I see that the Lord is going to open heaven here.
Eu vi que o Senhor vai abrir o céu aqui. Aleluia.
I see that the Lord is going to open heaven here.
Eu vi que o Senhor vai abrir o céu aqui.
And I see the drizzles of the rain of the Holy Spirit.
E eu vi também a chuva do Santo Espírito.
The drizzles.
As gotas.
Aleluia.
Aleluia.
Let me record the rain first.
It's raining.
It's raining.
Let me record the rain. It's raining. It's raining.
It's raining.
Let me record the rain.
Hallelujah. I'm Bishop Fernando from São Paulo, Brazil. We are here at Ground Zero, preparing for the Grand Healing Service. And the rain starts to fall. As the mighty prophets of the Lord said yesterday, they saw already the rain of the Lord coming, falling, and we are here.
Powerful.
Hallelujah. Very powerful, very mighty.
You ain't got the man, mighty, you ain't got the man.
Yeah. glory, revival. Jesus, fire, glory, revival. Jesus,
power, glory, revival, fire, Jesus, glory.
Equipo Hasbro. Hey! Fungueni mapito.
Open.
Fungueni
mapito.
Open. Open the way.
Fungueni mapito.
Look at there. Look at the way the Lord has healed you for
you.
A people is walking. Live on TV, live on national TV, not my son.
Where are you? 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 Where are
Lord has spoken with me this past night.
Bwana amenena pamoja nami usiku huu uliopita.
And I see a lot of missiles.
Na ninaona makombora mengi kabisa.
I don't know how many thousands of missiles fired.
Sijui ni maelfu ya makombora mangapi ambayo yanalipuliwa.
And they are fired towards Israel.
Na inalipuliwa kuelekea Israeli.
And also Iranian plus Syrian missiles, thousands and thousands of missiles fired at Israel.
Na pia ninaona makombora ya Irani na pia ya Washuri ikilipua kuelekea katika Waisraeli.
The Lord did take me to Israel.
Bwana alinipeleka Israeli.
And he showed me a lot of missiles coming like fire. They are red. They will be red in color.
Na alinionyesha makombora mengi mengi kabisa yakija kama moto yatakuwa mekundu katika rangi yake.
Fired towards Israel.
Ikilipuliwa kuelekea Israeli.
It was unbelievable.
Ilikuwa ya kutoaminika.
So we are sitting on the verge of a major war on the earth.
Hivyo tumekaa katikati ya ukingo wa vita vikali kabisa duniani.
This is going to be a historic war.
Hivi vinaenda kuwa vita vya kihistoria.
This is a prophecy I'm giving on this 26th day.
Hivyo huu ni unabii ambao ninapeana tarehe hii ya 26.
The month of July.
Mwezi wa July.
The year 2020.
Mwaka wa 2020.
The Lord again took me to Israel.
Bwana tena alinipeleka Israeli.
And he showed me the danger that is coming to Israel.
Na alinionyesha hatari ambayo inakuja kwa Israeli.
The Lord took me again there this past night.
Bwana tena alinipeleka huko usiku huu uliopita.
And he showed me how the Iranians are planning.
Na kunionyesha jinsi ambavyo Wairania wanapanga.
This time it will be unbearable. Thousands and thousands of missiles they want to fire towards Israel.
Wakati huu
itakuwa, that they will fire.
Wakati huu itakuwa ya kutoaminika kabisa maelfu juu ya maelfu ya makombora ambayo watalipua kuelekea Israeli.
It was unbearable.
Ilikuwa kutovumilika kabisa.
The earth right now is sitting on the verge of a major, major war.
Dunia sasa hivi limeketi katika ukingo wa vita vikali sana sana.
Of a very serious war.
Ya vita vya kumaanisha kabisa.
That might escalate.
Ambavyo vinaweza kuongezeka.
It will involve Israel.
Itahusisha Israeli.
And in that war, Israel might use nuclear weapons.
Na katika vita hivyo, wenda Israeli watumie vifaa vya kinuklia.
It is going to be a serious war the earth has not seen.
Ivinaenda kwa vita vya kumaanisha kabisa ambavyo dunia haijawahi kuona.
And in that dream,
na katika hiyo ndoto,
I took my position.
Nilichukua sehemu yangu.
And I declared,
na nikaamrisha,
before the Lord,
mbele za Bwana,
that Israel must win this war.
Ya kwamba lazima Israeli washinde hivi vita.
So there is going to be a battle, but Israel must win.
Kwa hivyo kunaenda kuwepo na vita, lakini Israeli lazima washinde.
Because the Lord has declared.
Kwa sababu Bwana ametangaza.
Thank you.
Asanteni.
Hit the earth, and this is very urgent. There's a very, very severe that is just about to hit the earth because of idolatry, idol worship on this earth, that they have chosen to worship other gods other than Jehovah. There's a very, very severe earthquake that is coming to the earth. Again, there is a very, very severe earthquake. The earth is right now sitting on the verge of a very, very severe earthquake that is about to take place. A very, very severe earthquake is about to hit the earth. And I see people running, a lot of people running. And I see many people buried. I see buildings that have crumbled down, different floors have crumbled down on each other. And there are people inside there. The earth is right now sitting on the verge of a very, very severe earthquake. A huge earthquake that will tumble down buildings. I am announcing that the earth is sitting on the verge of a very, very severe earthquake. Extremely severe. And I see people that are light-skinned. They're light-skinned, they're running. The Messiah is coming. The Lord, my voice, he said, tell these people to repent and I will restore them. Otherwise, they shall know that the Lord God has spoken. And that's a very serious conversation, a serious message whereby the Lord is giving mankind two choices, either to repent and be restored or to face the wrath of God. And the Lord is saying that time is over, the Messiah is coming. Because the Bible in the book of Matthew chapter 24, verse 7, it says there will be famines and earthquakes in various places right before the Messiah returns. And now you understand that these earthquakes were alluding to the coming of the voice that is speaking with you and were pointing directly to repentance. They were tied to repentance and the preparing of the way for the coming of the Messiah, the judging of the unrepentant nations and repentant men. Has the mouth of the Lord spoken with you? There is a historic fire coming. A historic fire is coming. It's not possible to run away from the fire. It is moving very fast. A huge fire that burns an entire settlement. The whole settlement is totally burned. I see children who have been burnt. People's homes have been burnt, totally burnt, and the fire was racing. The flames were moving so fast, angry flames. The danger was for the fire to come and close us in there. So people were running towards the exit where they can get out of that entire area. But the fire arrived there and kept them in. So people are burnt, babies, children have been burnt, big people, houses totally destroyed. It's a very, very harsh fire. There is a serious fire that is coming, serious. It's going to burn down an entire settlement. We tried to run, you could not. The flames were moving much faster. There was no escape. The Lord is calling for repentance.
This is an NBC News special report. This surveillance video from the night before showing a sudden flash.
The flames arrived with terrifying speed.
Oh no, guys! No, we have to leave!
As a family stuck in a line of cars had minutes to escape before the flames engulfed the road out.
You had no idea that as you were evacuating, you were actually heading into the firestorm.
I didn't know.
The brush fire was so quick, with the walls of fire caving in, Rivera had no time to get out.
The devastating wildfires in Hawaii, killing dozens of people now, destroying hundreds of homes and other buildings on the island of Maui. Those flames ravaging the historic city of Lahaina, once the capital of the Hawaiian kingdom.
The deadliest wildfire in modern American history.
The Lord Jehovah has spoken this past night very, very severely. I see an earthquake in one building, a whitish building in front of me collapses, a whitish building. And then the one on my right also collapses. Now, I have commanded the unbelievable earthquake of the Lord, the judgment of God, to come and strike the unrepentant generation, unrepentant people.
So there's a massive earthquake coming, and the building in front of me is a white building, and it collapses right in front of me there at my word in that dream. And as I was running towards the back, the right, then this one also collapses. There was a lot of running. Several buildings are going to be hit down, and people be running, and a lot of people buried. The judgment of God Almighty is come, and this earthquake is going to happen soon. Let everybody repent and prepare for the coming of the Messiah. Nobody can ignore the coming of the Messiah. Time is over.
This is CNN Breaking News.
More than 800 people have been killed by a powerful 6.8 magnitude earthquake, the strongest to hit the North African nation in more than a century.
So the quake struck late last night. It centered high in the mountains around the tourist destination of Marrakesh. The tremors brought down parts of it. Historic buildings and homes, and people just ran into the streets. Look at this video. Two men run when they begin to feel the shaking. And then moments later, you see panicked people running by, and then rubble falling where those men were just moments before.
There you go. There's a rubble falling. Nearly 700 people were reportedly injured in the quake. And now there is a race to reach the victims in the most affected area. But officials say rescue teams are struggling to get to some of these places.
Thousands of people have been killed in a powerful 6.8 magnitude quake in Morocco.
Well, blessed people, the Lord has spoken with me. This past night, the Lord Jehovah spoke with me, precious people, and he spoke with me about a tremendous event that is coming to take place on the earth. The Lord Jehovah spoke and said, you can now speak judgment upon the face of the earth. And then at that time, I see very, very historic floods that are coming to the earth. Very historic, absolutely historic. And this tsunami of floods that is coming has come out of a storm in the ocean. There is huge flood, so the Lord put me in that flood. And then I saw the two prophets of the Lord running now. There was nowhere to run to because the flood coming from the ocean was a more massive flood, greater flood, and a greater tide, a greater height. And people were running all across the board. And then after that, the Lord said, tell these people to repent and prepare the way. The Messiah is coming.
I see historic floods coming to the earth. Historic floods are coming to the earth. Unbelievable. Unbelievable floods. And everything everywhere was totally flooded, inundated. From the homes to the roads to the fields to everything. And you know, in that case, normally the Lord puts us in there, so we also try to run and try to get through the water. And so there are floods coming to the earth. Historic floods are going to hit the earth. And so I see historic floods coming. It will create a distress. It was quite vast. We were trying to cross through some areas. It was unbelievable. So every part was covered by floods, and you know, people are trying to pass by vehicles, by bike, by everything, on foot. It was just impossible. It will impact the earth very massively, very negatively also. And the Lord is asking for repentance, that the nations may turn away from sin and prepare for the coming of the Messiah. So this life does not stay forever. It comes to an end. The book of Hebrews chapter 9, 27, 28, unto every man is an appointment with death, right? Ecclesiastes chapter 11 verse 3, death is simply a door into the judgment of God, a door into eternity. The Lord is coming to shake the comforts of this generation, and floods are coming. Historic floods are coming to the earth. Thank you very much. The Lord bless you.
This is CNN Breaking News.
We begin with another devastating natural disaster in North Africa. Libya is now coping with major flooding that has wiped out entire villages and reportedly killed thousands of people.
Devastation felt across the world as the country of Libya searches for those lost in catastrophic flooding.
The Libyan community here is united in its efforts to help with this catastrophe.
Torrential rains produced by Mediterranean Storm Daniel as it dumped 6 to 9 inches of rain across eastern Libya. And up to 16 inches of rain fell in the city of Albeda in just one day. The rain, too much to withstand, collapsing two dams and sending the city of Derna underwater.
It came so fast and all of a sudden, and it just, the dams couldn't handle it. So they both broke. And of course, downstream was Derna, and it just got inundated.
The deadly rushing water swept the streets and extended for miles.
Then you had all this water rushing into Derna.
Extreme flooding in Europe. At least 7 people are dead in Greece, Turkey, and Bulgaria after the region was hit with torrential rain.
Storm Daniel's biblical rains turned the river that divides the city of Volos in central Greece into an angry torrent. Greek officials say the rains that began on Monday were the heaviest ever recorded. Authorities warned residents to keep off the roads, with the mayor of Volos wading into the floodwaters himself to plead with residents.
Where do you think you're going? Go back home. The rivers are going to break their banks. There's a lot of water coming.
Torrential rain struck Bulgaria's Black's 2 casualties and widespread flooding. The deluge transformed streets into surging rivers, particularly in the Sarajevo region, where floodwaters were deep enough to submerge cars. Rivers breached their banks, necessitating the evacuation of tourists near Sarajevo. In addition, a bridge collapsed south of the city, with reports of 3 individuals missing, damaging bridges and isolating the entire region south of Burgas.
Are becoming increasingly common in Turkey's largest city. A month's worth of rain fell within hours in Istanbul. Several streets turned into rivers, and dozens of cars were washed away. Officials say they received around 4,000 emergency calls, and floodwaters damaged 2,000 homes and businesses. Tourists were also swept away by a torrent that raged through a campsite in the northwestern city of Kırklareli.